we go. Training log, January. Watch out for the sun. 20th, 2024, Saturday, deadlifts. So usually I like to deadlift when I'm training hard. I like to deadlift on Wednesdays, some variations, and I like to deadlift on Saturdays, some variations. So today, let's circle back. Wednesday, I did block pulls against bands. I was really working on like power and speed, and then I went down to deficit pulls against bands. Whoa, slippery. Okay, so that was major work, doing a heavy block pull against band over 500 pounds, and then doing, I think, fives of deficits up to dang near 400 pounds on the bar plus the band. So today, I wanted to do deadlifts, but not like kill my back. So I thought rack pulls, but traditionally rack pulls, I tend to hurt my lower back because I like a rack pull right about the kneecaps, and I usually push through with my lower back to finish it off. And then obviously my lower back starts hurting if I'm just beating it up like that. So today I came in there and I said, let me try something different. And I tried my wider stance. So it wasn't sumo stance, it was the moderate stance. And I really was focusing on flexing my upper lat. So like up here, your wings, you can't see up here. Flex that at the top. And I liked the movement. So I had a stair stepper, the aerobic stair stepper underneath me, because the rack arms didn't go low enough. So I needed a little bit of extra height adjusted. Put on my figure eight straps. Just kind of found a good technique and equipment and position that I liked, and I could really flex my lats at the top and stand tall and proud and kind of hold it for an isometric hold for a minute. Goal was, let's hit some heavy weights since it's just a short range of motion and kind of hold it at the top. So after I messed around for a bit figuring out what was gonna hit the areas I wanted to, I got into it. So I just went one plate, two plates, three plates, and I was doing triples, moved really nice. So at that point I said, let's start going up by quarters instead of just plate jumps to give me a little bit more time to adjust and get accustomed to the weights. Triple at 365, car sliding, didn't get hit by anybody. Triple at 365, triple at 405, triple at 455, triple at 495, triple at 545. Now I'm putting 585 on the bar. And I go back to, I read Westside Barbell Book of Methods, Louis Simmons from Westside Barbell Gym, famous power lifter. In that book, he says, if you're doing rack pulls, you know, don't let your ego get the best of you. Only go like 10% over your one rep max. Otherwise, hell, if I can only pull 600 off the ground and I'm going to like 800 on the block pulls, there's no point to it. I'm never gonna touch 800. So don't go crazy with the weights is what Louis Simmons said. And I had that in my mind. So 585 on the bar, I'm not gonna go up to 635, which would be five plates and quarters. Let me just test this thing out. So got suited and booted, got my mind right, and I pulled 585 for what I'll say is five solid reps without seeing it on camera. In fact, the fifth rep felt the strongest. No strain on my lower back. Just really flexing my lats and kind of flexing my hamstrings and standing tall and proud. So that's great, man. That's near 100% of my one rep max. I did it five times. I held it tall and proud, and it was great. Okay, so I'm done with that. That really wasn't that taxing on me as far as breaking me down. So I said, let me do some sumo pulls, which the way I've been pulling sumo are really just really working those lats again. Not that much leg drive to them because I kind of go up and over the bar. If I get too much leg drive, I tweak my knee. So I worked up to, I did 135 for five, 225 for five, 315 for five, then I did 405 for five. They weren't easy, but the way I was doing it, like I said, it was really putting the work into my lats. So that's what I wanted to work on today. Not that full range of motion explosiveness that I was doing on Wednesdays. Really wanted to just beat up the top end and think about absolute strength, not power and speed of the movement. So 405 for five, great, good. I did some cable rows, some lat pulls, and some ab work after that. So very good workout. I had a great time. It was fun figuring that out. And then got my volume in, jumped on the treadmill. Because again, if you can run a mile reasonably fast, you might as well just do a mile instead of going home and skipping it. How long are you gonna be sitting in front of the TV today? Or how long are you gonna be sitting on your phone? How long are you gonna be just staring at the wall because you're bored? Might as well do your 10-minute run. So I didn't need 10 minutes. I did a mile in about 7:25. That's not pushing it too hard, but it was a nice pace. It felt good, it felt comfortable. Finished that, jumped into the sauna for 20 minutes. Just sweating. I love to go to the sauna, get a good sweat on. I feel like it's changing my oil. Let's drain all that water I drank out yesterday, replenish again today. So great workout. Probably focusing on some running tomorrow. Looking at deadlift through this week. The Wednesday, Saturday workouts were great. Getting back into it, enjoying myself, having fun. Couple videos. I got the rack pulls and I got the sumos. Check them out. We'll be at it again tomorrow. See ya. Come on.